So first, I would like to ask all of you from English parts. So 你们有没有看到过一些非常 embarrassing 或者是 weird 的英语？在中国，阿明在中国看到过吗？
我看过了。
你看到的是什么？
我看到很多很多纹身，他们写错了，所以他们有不对的 spelling。
我也看到。
哇，是不对的 spelling， 那它的意思呢？它的意思是好的还是有点奇怪的？
对，但是他们写的不对，所以看不好看。
不好看，也可能会看不懂，对吧？
对，然后很多很多我遇到的人，中国人，他们问我，哦，我做了这个纹身，是对的吗？然后让我感觉不好，因为我不想让他们尴尬，因为这个纹身是 permanent， 所以如果不对怎么办？
哦，对对对，就不想让他们尴尬，因为你已经有了一个纹身了。哦，那其实例子你看到的是什么让你觉得很奇怪的英语的纹身？
哦，我有一个中文朋友，他看到我的纹身的是 like Chinese one， 他告诉我，哦，我有一个英语的纹身。
嗯，
你看一下 ，she like across his shoulders。
Uh-huh.
还有是 English only God can J-U-G-E me， 但是是不是 judge， 是 only God can juke me， 没有 D。
Yeah， 你没说 J-U-G-E， 他应该是想 J-U-D-G-E，
但是 like yeah， 写错了 J-U-G-E， 所以是 only God can juke me， 是没有 like但是是 like 真的好看。
Only adds irony to this quote.
Only like yeah, only the script was 真的好看，还有 like beautiful tattoo. But 没有意思是错的 like only God can juke me. So like 哦，好看，好看。
哦，太可惜了吧！这么好看，但是错了一个 spelling。那其实要不他也想和我们分享，除了 tattoo 以外。我们在生活中也会常常看到让人很尴尬的英语，比如说这个，这个是 Yap 你看到的吗？
我很喜欢这个。
But actually, yeah, Mickey Mouse and then the sewer rat underneath. Actually, I don't know if this is a mistake because I think it's quite funny actually. And then the same for a family poisoned by eating a lemon pie. I don't know if that's I don't know if the wearer of this shirt knows the meaning. It's still a bit funny.But foreigners will laugh at Chinese people and then the spelling, or are they really sure what they are wearing, what the meaning is of this? But actually the opposite is true just as often.
I found these two pictures online.
Yeah, dead inside and leave me alone. So maybe they wear this, but they don't know the meaning.
Hey, I'm really curious.你们如果看到一个人他穿的衣服有英语，你们会去读吗？会去读他是什么意思吗？
当然。
那如果是汉语呢？你们会去看吗？
我试一试，但是我经常不懂。
经常不懂，所以你们会看英语？
看英语。
对，因为我有一个很尴尬的衣服。我是很着，因为天气很热，我很着急买了一件 T-shirt， 颜色很漂亮，是那种非常 like light green， 就是很好看的颜色。But when I wear it, I realize 它的英语是告诉别人我喝酒很厉害，我喝三天不会醉。我想，我再也没有穿过那件衣服。所以你看英语，你们会觉得很奇怪。其实很多人他们身上的汉语也会让我们觉得很奇怪，比如这个，你们都认识汉字，那这两个汉字你们觉得有意思吗？
躲过it 好听的 it sounds really nice but
你觉得它听起来很好听？
躲过 maybe not then no
但是你们知道它是什么意思吗？放在一起，没有意思，
没有意思 ，like no，
没有意思。对，我在想锁这个地方是所以，或者是一个地方可以是锁。狗我们都知道就是 puppy dog，
嗯，
你放在一起，你觉得这两个字看起来好看吗？
不好看，
也不好看。所以我也非常想知道，哎，不好听，不好看，没有意思，你为什么要贴一个彩色？
嗯，
对。所以一般你们会因为什么去找一个 tattoo？ 这个我们一会儿可以再聊一聊。还有这里，这个我也觉得，嗯
，the hell，
这第一个字它是把它 upside down 了。
哦，
哎，他们一点 OK。
嗯，如果把它放成一个是真正的汉字，它应该是一个苦 bitter。
嗯，
啊、这个阿呆，阿呆的话其实。嗯，不是一个特别好的意思。
你觉得这个纹身是中国人或者外国人？
我觉得是一个外国人吧。如果是因为我遇到过一个纹身师，我告诉他我的想法，我给他的照片，他会告诉我这么难看，你确定你要纹身吗？我就觉得，哦，他非常的直接。如果是一个中国人，我觉得他会直接告诉你这三个字不好。
对。
嗯，而且我听说在欧洲有一些纹身师，如果他们要想给别人纹汉字，他们需要有一个 license， 他们才可以去纹汉字，这是真的吗？你们没有听过对吗？
没有听过，
没有听过。
啊，我是看到有一个 post， 它上面说，对，就是为了让这样的情况不要再发生，所以有些纹身师他们需要有汉语的 license。我想哇，纹身还要学汉语啊，但是我觉得 it's necessary now。 OK， 还有这个所以这个嗯，可能这个字看起来有点好看吧，但是也是没有什么意思。
为什么？为什么
啊？为什么？对，为什么要纹这两个字？
长笨哇，
训。嗯，然后是意思是你很快的就变笨了吗？还有这个
，Oh my god！
我感觉现在，嗯，可能前面的照片会让你们以后会让你们再想一想，我要不要有一个汉字的纹身？啊，这个字我真的。
哦，不好意思，好像。
什么
啊？等一下，我的
这个看起来小学生写了，然后也很大，真的很，
应该是在这个二。
对，
嗯，
我觉得他像他的 tattooist 对的 ，like either like I think she's asked for the right thing, he's just put them the wrong way around。
哦，所以我觉得
或者 like。I 和 John, like 在英国 like maybe we ask, okay, well for my, I'll show you later, but for, we want this, our tattoo to mean this, so he like 看到 okay, 这个 put them the wrong way around. So maybe the tattooist didn't realize, I think that's maybe the story behind this one. Good intentions, but very bad placement.
对对，我觉得有可能，因为这三个字它的意思是很好的意思。
嗯。
但是这个 calligraphy 就觉得嗯不好看，然后呢，这个就像刚才例子说，这个 order 也是有问题的。OK， and this one， 这个也是非常的嗯。
This one is easy to fix.
Yeah, I think this can get covered.
嗯。
Can just add a line.
是的，是的，而且这个 actually is a wrong character， 这个汉字都是不对的。他想说的是 wife 的话应该是这个汉字妻，但是他写的是舞女。我觉得他的这个第一个字想说的是这个，因为这个汉字他的意思是我的，这个意思是我的，所以说舞女可能是 my wife 是我的女人 kind of like that。 但是他写了还是一个不对的字，五个女人，你想要五个妻子吗？ 还有这个。所以嗯，他可能 cover 或者是有很长的头发可以去 cover。
This is like translated from live in the now or like live today, probably. But then the Chinese, this doesn't work in Chinese like this. Live in the now.
I guess it's also they have this idea of the combination. So put the words together and then the meaning.
I think the problem with these tattoos comes from them using like Google Translate. And they just put in live in the present and then this comes up. It's like translation is not, it's not always going to be the correct meaning, right?
Yeah, there's even one method which is worse than Google Translate, which is on the next slide. because
这个要不你看懂了吗？
没有。
你们谁可以看得懂？
我也看不懂。
我看得懂两个汉字，难怪，但是一起看不懂这个意思。
这个，但是我觉得这个字是好看的。
对，他问的很好。他问的很好，
纹的很好。
纹的很好，对对对，这个字很好看，纹的它的 skills 也非 technicals 也很好。是这个意思是什么？没有人能看得懂。So, 我看到这张照片的时候，我以为是一个 old saying， 我不知道，所以我去百度，然后我发现没有一个 old saying 是这句话，所以这个也是没有意思的。OK， 所以你们看，如果让你们选择 ，if you which character you feel like。This can be very nice, good meaning, and also in a good form.
Yeah, you can just translate your name like this to Chinese characters.
真的？ Wow.
对，有些字是好看的，但是有些字放在一起 is like meaningless.
Yeah, mine is like fast north problem, L-I-Z, 快北京。
快 fast.然后难，是有些字我觉得，
他的名字是什么
？Paulo，Paulo，
我太慢读汉字，
没关系没关系 ，OK， 所以你看这些是一些不好的汉字的纹身的 examples，我们来可以看一些好的，这个汉字。它是有点像行书 calligraphy 当中的一个行书，它是很好看的，而且勇士爱它也是有意思的。还有这个人 Justin Bieber， 他有点点小，但是我觉得和他的工作有关系，因为他是一个歌手，所以他把这个歌放在了他的纹身上。还有这个我也是第一次看到他有这个纹身。
上帝你唱。
对，上帝就是 God， 与你，对，因为这个与它是一个 traditional 的汉字，它不是我们现在看到的 simplify， 然后与你常在，常就是我们指的 often， 所以是上帝与你常在。OK， 还有这个，我觉得这个人你们认识吗？要不你认识吧，你可以介绍一下吗？
也不是非常有名，有点十年前的球员 football player。对，马丁纳，就是他女儿的名字。
我以为是他太太的名字，是他女儿的名字啊。
对对对，他女儿的名字。
他的名字是 Fabio。
对 ，Fabio Cannavaro。
所以 Jenna 你知道，对，他会把对他来说很重要的人的名字放在自己的身上。然后你看这第一个的话其实也是个 traditional character。他马的话，马就是那个 horse， 他的右边是有 simplified。还有这个。这个人是谁我还真不知道。这个我们很熟悉了。这个是真的很好看。 这个是生死有命，它是 the first half， 富贵在天 the second half。 那生死就是 life and death， 我们都是有自己的 like destiny 或者是 determined appointment。 富贵每个人想到的 rich 或者是 fortune， 在天 it depends on the God。 好，那我们可以再来了解一下，其实在中国纹身的历史和文化已经有很长时间了。诶，我想先问一问，你们身上有这么多 tattoo， 或者你想做 tattoo 做纹身的时候，你觉得你的爸爸妈妈会是什么态度？他们的 attitude 是怎么样的？ Also for me， 我有两个纹身，我的妈妈看到了第一个，她很生气。然后我的妈妈可能看到我的照片有第二个，她很生气了。她发微信给我，用英语的意思啊，英语的意思就是 Do you want to go to the hill？
Oh my gosh，
生气。但是我有在考虑我的第三个纹身嘛，就我不要让她知道就可以了。
It's funny you told me you went home for a spring festival or something and then you forgot to wear socks.Because they would cover the tattoo. And then your mom saw it.
是的，是的。所以现在我回家，因为我的有一个纹身是在脚上，夏天如果我穿 shorts 或者是 dress 是可以看到的，但是我夏天都是会穿很长的 socks 回家。所以在中国的话，其实中国很多爸爸妈妈是不他们会觉得有纹身的人不是好人，他们会觉得有纹身不是好人的，他们会觉得你的就会给他们会有一种那种就是有一点 stereotype， 觉得有纹身的呢可能是就是没有什么很好的工作啊，没有学习很多啊，就会觉得你是一个奇怪的，不是一个好的人。 But actually we already have a very long history. You see, it's already thousands of years ago. And alsoThe meaning is quite good, 精忠报国. And when I prepared for the event, I just realized, oh, because all the students in Chinese school, they learn this story. They also know the mom makes a tattoo for his boy, but it's also in our book. 所以我在想啊，这是告诉大家你们要去做纹身吗？No, I just realized this idea, butAt that time, we just learned the meaning of 精忠报国 is quite good, serve for the country. That's all. 我们没有说啊，这是纹身，我们只说这是很好的意思。对，所以你看，这是精忠报国，还有有一些不好的意思。It's kind of like the punishment, and also the place on your body. It will be very specific on your face, on your neck.And so it's very obvious to show others you are the criminals. You got this punishment. So that's why you have this tattoo. And also the tattoos like the area and also the color and the words depends on what kind of the crime you made. 所以这个以前是一个不太好的 symbol. 现在在云南有一个很特别的 culture, 一个很特别的文化。你看在他们的脸上 on their face 有纹身，而且这个纹身是他们12岁的时候开始做的。那现在在脸上有这个纹身的人，我看了一下网上，他们说只有36个人了。 Only 36 people left they have this tattoo because of the culture. 他们是 minority,是叫独龙族，在云南。 And also why they have this tattoo? Because they think they use the tattoo to cover your beauty, then you can protect yourself. 我觉得这个是非常 ridiculous 的想法。 Yeah, but it's also very, so from my side, I think it's also very sad because also this minority, they not get a very,close connection to the outside world. They live in the mountain and then still very closed and also live a very like conventional and also very old style life. 这个是在云南，很多人他们会去这个地方旅游，去看他们脸上的纹身。但是现在我听说他们 is not allowed for the outsiders to get inside of the village， 他们不可以了，因为想要保护他们的文化。
嗯
嗯，而且在中国，在中国，嗯，他会给你 cover 你的纹身的，电视还有一些 TV shows 新闻。你是 celebrity， 你是 superstar， 你也不可以让大家看到你的纹身。这个是在中国的电视。
Yeah, I've seen on Chinese TV shows. My favorite one, Street Dance of China, just finished. A lot of the French, the French dancers have tattoos, so they all every week they would be covered up, like neck, hands, like everything all blurred out. I noticed that. I didn't realize that.Even though they're not celebrities, like they had to have all of their tattoos covered or blurred out for the TV show every week.
对的，对的。So you are seeing the mask, and also maybe they will use different clothes to cover the tattoos if they're on TV. 哎，所以在如果是在欧洲，如果你们有一些人在 TV show， 他们有一些非常 obvious， 非常明显的纹身，他们需要去 cover 吗？他们可以给别人看吗？没关系，
可以。
哦，所以在中国很奇怪，你看这个贝克汉姆他的纹身都没有了。It's a lot of work for the Photoshop.
Yeah.
在中国的话，还是我觉得大家的 is not very like open-minded enough to accept the tattoo culture. 好，那现在我们也想看一下。If you choose the characters of the tattoo, actually, it's very important to choose the right meaning and also very important to choose the form of the characters. 那哎 ，Jenna， 你的那个汉字它是什么字体 form？ 你知道吗 ？What kind of the form？ 啊，我看一下你的照片。
我发给你们的照片。
看到了，因为
这个纹身是我的朋友 Daga Poki， 他只做每个纹身一次，所以如果他经常纹了符，但是都不一样的style， 不一样的风格。
对，很可爱。我觉得Jenna， 你的这个字有一点点像这个隶书，对，其实就是中国的书法 calligraphy。你可以找到隶书，是很它隶书的特点是 it's flat and a little bit fat, kind of like more cute. 它是比较可爱的扁扁的字体，这是隶书。那还有的人，你们也可以考虑选择这个草书。草书 is very cool and also it's depend it makes you feel like it's a cool kind of person and also it's very every lines are very smooth. 所以这个是草书。但是 it's very hard to understand what is the exact meaning. 看不懂。这个是比较我们经常能看到的楷书。楷书呢 is, we will say it looks like a good student's writing. 它就是写出来是非常好看的。那between 草书 and 楷书 it's my favorite one. We can say 行书。So, 行书是非常好看的。它是在草书和楷书的中间一种 style， 所以你们可以去想一想中国的书法，中国的意思，然后去选择你想要的汉字。Okay, and also now it's Jenna's time. How to choose a Chinese tattoo and also choose a 纹身师 in China?
So I think it's
yeah,
I don't know you prepared this.So all of my tattoos that I've had I've been in China, and I've only used three different tattoo artists. So the first one was one of my friends in Chongqing. I used to live in Chongqing, and my first tattoo that I had was it's the molecule tattoo, which means caffeine. So maybe I can just show you.
Wow.
This one here. Can you see that?
Wow. 很酷。
So it's very simple, and it didn't really matter like who did it. Do you know what I mean? Because it's not a specific style. It's just a symbol. So whoever did this symbol, it would look the same regardless. So for me, it was, I just chose my friend's friend because there was some relationship there. I didn't want to just go to a stranger. I was really scared the first time I got a tattoo. Like, I you know how Jap said that he hasn't had a tattoo yet because you don't know what to choose and you don't know which tattooist to go to, and you don't know if it's going to be too painful and all of these things. And then one day I was just like, I'm just going to go and get it and see what happens. So I just chose my friend's friend. And then the second tattoo, and then almost all of my tattoos were done by Fidi, who's a tattoo artist. But I think this is the thing that you need to know is like, you need to do some research about the person's style. So actually my tattoos are not the style that he prefers to do. They're not in his style. So he's like designed them specifically for me based on my ideas, but they're not in line with the tattoos that he usually does. So I think if you guys want to choose a tattoo in China and choose a tattoo artist, you really need to do research on their style and their previous tattoos and the way that they like to do tattoos. Because if you've got an idea and you want it to be executed, you should find the person who can execute it the best way. Does that make sense?
Mm. Yeah, I was just going to say I completely agree. And I've just noticed you're from Cardiff. So this is my, I lived there for 12 years before I came here. But what you were saying about finding an artist, I think is, well, like the guy who did my koi tattoo is like one of Cardiff's UK's award-winning tattooists, but he does new school style. So he wasn't used to doing Japanese stuff, but he still did his best. And I wish I'd taken what you said, or even fathomed it, that you need to look at the style of what they do best. He did a great job, but it wasn't like his thing. So I think you need to consider like what their style is. Like,
exactly what you said. Like, if you want to have a Japanese style tattoo, you need to find, in my opinion, you need to find the best Japanese style tattooist around, and you need to go to them to get it, because it's going to be more expensive because they're a specialist, right? But it's going to be on your body for the rest of your life. Yep. So why wouldn't you want to spend money on that to have the best version of it that you can? Whereas like, if like, for example, Fidi style is Chicano, which is like Mexican LA kind of gangster style. So if you want that kind of style, then he's the best person to go to. But if you want some like delicate flowers or something, not the best person to go to.
Wow. Did you have a good lot of research before you do the tattoo? I just choose the one and show him my idea, and then he helped me design. So I'm still very lucky.
Because there's a lot of tattoo artists in China who specialize in a specific style. Like, I know one girl in Shanghai, and she's very delicate, and she can do like tiny detailed tattoos with like very like fine lines. But maybe there's another tattooist who does realistic photorealism tattoos. So you have to find the person who does the style the best and then seek your design from them, and also have an original idea, or try and have an original idea and get them to draw it for you. Because it's a piece of art. It's their in like, what's it called? It's like, it's their personal property in a way. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So if you have an idea that you saw on the internet and you want that tattoo, then you should go to that person and get them to tattoo you. Don't take their photo to another artist and get them to try and copy it.
It's not very good, and also it's implied, I think.
Yeah, it's kind of like a copyright thing. It's like stealing their idea.
是的, yes. But I did it a lot. I said, look for the pictures online, which one I like.
Yeah. And if you don't know, like, if you don't know an artist, you can always look online. Like, if you're looking in China, maybe Instagram's not the best place, but Xiao Hongshu has so many.
是的, 小红书, I think it's quite good. And also kind of like Instagram in China, something like Instagram.
All you need to do is like search hashtag Shanghai Wénshēn. You can find so many.
是的, wow. 所以我觉得像 Jenna, 她现在也可以是一个 specialist of tattoo.
那个汉字。我的纹身都是在中国做的。 So all of my tattoos were done in China. All 12 of them. So this one is my Chinese character. So Fu.
So
this is Fu. This is Fu Dao.
Ah.
对，这个是中国的很重要的一个意思。
My cardigan made my skin so weird.
可以看，我觉得很清楚，嗯，可以看得很清楚。But
this one is a hand poke tattoo.
Oh, 对对对，上次 Jenna 告诉我，它是那种就是一点，就是用手一点，花了很长时间呢。It sounds hurt, so that's why I don't want to experience that.
It's yeah. It's not that bad, and it took about two hours.
Wow, 2 hours 其实是这么小的一个 tattoo, 2个小时，时间有点长了。对。 哦，哇，真的很酷。那其实我们在选择纹身的话， also if we have time, maybe we can got some new ideas for Chinese tattoo. So 你可以是名字、汉字，或者是一个idiom，或者是一个 zodiac, 或者是你的朋友这种不同的。 So I think Jenna and Liz already have more than 10 tattoos on their body. I'm wondering if like a Ubi and also Nils, Erica, what kind of the tattoo? If you have the chance to make, what do you want? And also Yak, 你有想过你要做纹身吗?
A lot of ideas, but nothing that is strong enough to say, okay, I'm gonna take this and keep it forever. But, and also, especially relating to Chinese tattoos, that's maybe a question to you all, because we're all learning Chinese and Chinese characters, but we progress quite quickly. In the space of 2 or 3 years, we learn a lot of characters, and our feeling to this character also changes. Like in Heiskit 2, maybe a character looks very profound, but now you progress, and then the character, your attitude towards this character changes. And I know Jenna has Fu, but that's like exception, because it's such a much bigger meaning than the character itself. This is not really a question, is it? But
the reason that I chose Fu is because, like, even though it's a very common character, it's a character that like follows me around, and I just, and that sounds really weird, but like I find myself in situations often outside of, obviously you're going to see it everywhere on doors and things like that, but I mean outside of that context, I find Fu in my life. Like one time when I went to Chengdu, I went to the temple and there was a huge one on the wall. I bought a spoon. This sounds really stupid, but I bought a spoon in the shop because I needed a spoon quickly, and I just bought one spoon and it has Fu on it. And like, I just like keep meeting Fu in so many weird places that you wouldn't expect to find it. And I feel like it's with me. If that makes sense.
Oh, it's like everywhere, and also bring very good luck.
Yes, hopefully.
对，这是你的幸运物，哦，很棒。 Yeah, so, but after this event, I still have no idea about the Chinese tattoos I want.
I think people put so much pressure on the meaning of the tattoo. Like, I think, especially with words, like with a picture, or an image, I think you can just choose something that you like. And then if people ask you what it means, you'll say, well, it's meaningful to me. Don't worry about it. But if it's a word, then it's like everybody can understand that word. Like if it's an English word, everyone can understand the meaning. If you're in China and you've got a Chinese tattoo, especially as a foreigner, like that's a lot of pressure for the meaning to be meaningful or to make sense or to be worth having that tattoo.
Wow, so it's really hard to make the decision.
I think there's a lot of, maybe there's a lot of judgment when it comes to word tattoos.
It's easy to understand from the, just like appearances, it's easy to understand and also to judge.
So I could have ba tattooed, my most hated Chinese grammar point, the ba for active verbs. No.
Oh,
I wouldn't, I wouldn't really, but I think if I, because I don't, I thought about getting a Chinese tattoo to kind of, so when I finally leave China, I think ba is probably the one that's going to stay with me for the rest of my life, being a Chinese learner.
把杯子拿过来把门关上, that's ba, right?
Yeah, I think if when I'm an old lady, if I looked at that, it would make me laugh about like how hard I found that grammar point to understand and how it took me 3 years to realize what it was for.
Oh, I hope the ba won't ruin your learning journey.
No, because now finally ba and me are friends, but I think genuinely when you say, oh, you might get one character, it's funny, but that I might do that.
This I can understand, yeah.
Yeah, you see that one ba, like, oh, that might be the only Chinese character I'd ever get now, but I wouldn't know where to put it because I want to see it all the time.
Maybe kind of
one of my friends, one of my friends got some tattoos. They're so meaningless, but she loves them. And they're on the finger, like one here, one here, one here. And they say, ah, ba, ya.
Really?
Like the word, the small words that you put at the end of sentences. Yep. And is the girl who did the tattoo was like, this is crazy. Why are you doing this? And she was like, I just want it. Do it.
Really? They already keep the tattoos for how long?
She's had it for like maybe 6 months.
Oh, 6 months. Any idea change or still like it?
No, she still likes it.
Yeah. Does she ever reply using them like, just show them?
Yeah.
People?
My answer.
Oh. So funny.
Do it. And also you can, if you have some friends and also play about tattoo and also you have like similar ideas, you can make the things together. Oh. 这个呢是 百善孝为先,万恶淫为首. It's also a very classical idiom from Chinese and also it's good if you can make the two sentences together. So later I can send you the characters in the group to help you to look for the meaning because 百善孝为先 is kind of be good for your parents. It's the first important thing. And second sentence is a little bit hard to explain because yin, this word, yin, it means like sexual desire. So sexual desire is the most, like the baddest thing. This is the sentence meaning. 所以这个是中国人的想法. Okay. And also, yep, give us some tips if you want to get some new, a good meaning and the characters. 恐惧会扼杀思维. Oh, this is all traditional characters. It's so complicated. It's very difficult for the.
This is a quote from the movie that's in the cinemas now, Dune, Xiaqiu. And they say, fear is the mind killer. And a lot of Dune fans have this quote in English. Tattooed, but if you're learning Chinese and maybe you, so also before this event, Lin, you said it's very personal to choose a tattoo, but then you can choose a single character, or like a combination, like a term, Ziyo or Wu Wei. There's also a Goi student who has Wu Wei.
This one.
Yeah, which is this old concept of not interfering and letting things go, its own flow.
Like go with the flow.
and not interfering and letting things run their own, yeah, go with the flow or letting things run their natural course. A very big concept. But there's also idioms like Yixian Yiyi, Junhua Qiushi, and or a quote like from Dune, fear is the mind killer. Mm-hmm.
对，这些都是亚族很喜欢的汉字和意思，对吧？
嗯、
，like 心上人、雨、爽 ，I know it's all your favorite。对，所以我们要选择你喜欢的 ，it's meaningful for you and also the in the good form. So then I believe you won't regret for the tattoo you got in the future.
Yeah, maybe you is the closest I have to a fool, but it's not like the character comes to me. I put the character in a lot of places.
是的 and also one tip, every time when you see some GoEast posters, you can look for 雨 from the poster.